staying safe and healthy. Well, today we're actually going to be investigating beaver dams. So get ready to gather some materials outside and get a little dirty. So before you get started building your river and beaver dam, you're going to need to find a location outside. Now, I chose a location by this tree, and I started to carve out my riverbed, which you'll be doing in a moment, because there's a little bit of gradient or slope that will help my water flow down and create a pond at the end after we build our beaver dam. So you want to have a little bit of a slope so your water can flow downwards. Now, before you get started, you're going to need some materials, and hopefully you've gathered those already. I have a shovel, a small shovel. I have some natural materials. This is what beavers really use to build their dam. Sticks. You need sticks of different sizes. Plants. Moss. They use a lot of moss. They might use some water plants. Rocks of different sizes beavers will use. And also some mud. And I'm going to create my mud as I flow my water down. I'll create a pocket of mud that I can use to build my dam as well. You are going to need a water source. I have a hose here so I can change the flow of the water that's flowing down. If you don't have a hose to use, you can use a water container, and you'll be able to fill that up and create your flow that way. Before we actually make our river flow, I wanted to tell you about where the water source is. So in Salem, we actually have 90 miles of streams and rivers. Any idea where that water comes from? So along the rivers that flow into our cities, there's many beaver dams, and beaver dams have an important environmental benefit. They block the flow of the river, which slows it down, but as they do that, it actually helps improve water quality. It'll make the water more clear as it slowly flows through. It's going to help with flooding and erosion, and hopefully you watch the video that I sent ahead of time. That way you would have an idea of exactly how beavers build dams and how the dam helps with the quality of the water. So before you get started, you might need to think about your river bed, the design of the river. Are you going to dig out a straight shot down from your mountain? We're going to pretend like this tree is my mountain, a straight channel that goes down. Are you going to make your riverbed curve or meander? The function of the riverbed will actually help improve water quality as well and create habitat for animals. So think about how you want to design your riverbed. This might be a good time to pause the video and think about how you want to design your riverbed. Do you want it to be straight so the water flow is speedy and goes fast, or do you want it to curve or meander? So the flow of the water is important. Obviously, if there's a lot of rainfall, the flow might be too much for the riverbed and there might be flooding. That also leads to erosion, the breaking down of the riverbanks. It moves all that natural material from place to place that should be stable. So we're going to start our water flow. Decide how you want to start it. Do you want to start a slow flow to see how your water flows through your riverbed? Or do you want it to be fast? So make a decision about that. Try out both ways. Pause the video and try it. So I decided that I'm going to start my flow kind of slow to get it going. I need my water to move from the top of my mountain, which is up here, which it naturally flows off of Mount Jefferson in real life, and it's going to flow down my riverbed. I'm just going to kind of help establish my riverbed to get the flow going. Turn up my flow a little bit. Remember, the source of your water, the source of your river, is up at the mountain. So I have my gradient or my slope that's going down, and my water is starting to gather. Rocks are also an important part of a river ecosystem. So I have gathered some rocks here that I showed you earlier, and I'm going to add some different sized rocks. Maybe you want to use some big rocks. Maybe you want to use some small pebbles. What happens to the rocks once you start your river flow again? So I'm adding rocks, so add some rocks. You can choose different sizes if you like. Start your river flow again and see what happens. Pause the video here and then we'll see what happens to those rocks as your river, as your water flows down the river. So now I'm going to flow the water down my riverbed through my dam. I hope you've had time to experiment yourself to see what happens when you change the water flow and how it flows through your dam. Let's give it a try. Okay. Here goes my water flow down my riverbed. I'm going to slow that flow a little bit. It's going through my dam. The dam is slowing the water flow. And look what's happening down here. Once the water is going through my dam, what do you notice about the shape of the riverbed? So try it again. Change the shape of your riverbed. See what happens after that. One other thing I wanted to try, because I've noticed by Battle Creek Elementary School, there is a wetlands there where beavers live, and we pick up garbage there sometimes with students, but I've noticed that beaver dams also trap a lot of pollutants like garbage. So I have just some little pieces of plastic that I wanted to try to flow down the riverbed to see if it could get trapped in the beaver dam. Beaver dams trap pollutants or chemicals or extra types of sediment that might make the water unhealthy as well. So let's try to float some pieces of trash down. We're going to pretend like some humans were walking around this natural area, some miniature humans, and they left their garbage on the ground. Let's see what happens to the plastic material as it flows down my riverbed and tries to make it through the dam. So you can see, as my plastic material flowed down the riverbed, it's getting trapped in the dam as well. And that's exactly how a dam would trap sediments that might be harmful. And if you find any of these little critters, these sweet little worms, make sure you save them and don't let them drown in your riverbed. These guys help our plants grow and we need these little critters. So I'll save that little guy's life. After you do your beaver investigation, make sure you take some time to think about what you learned. Reflection is always an important part of the learning process. What did you notice? What did you notice when you changed the shape of the riverbed? What did the dam do? Did it create a pond? So make sure you spend some time just relaxing in the sun and spending some quiet time in nature thinking about what you learned doing the beaver dam investigation. See you next time!